Hey, how's everybody doing? Welcome to today's edition of Lead Sites Live. Getting started here. Today we're going to be talking about lead site settings and what they do, things that you guys might not have seen before, things along those lines. So let's get going with it. So let's pop into our backend here. I'm gonna go ahead and go to the apps page. And let's start in the main settings tab here. So let's kind of go through what all these are. So this is your profile. This will be where your kind of phone numbers and anything that kind of displays front facing on the website is. So anywhere where like a profile info would be or a phone number or anything along those lines, that's where it's going to pop up. IDX profile, this is where you pop in your MLS name, your own agent ID, your broker name, your broker email, and your office ID. This is just information that's good to have on the site. In this section here, this is where you can set your active users. This is kind of a cool one. If you guys have a team, like a small team, basically, you can add new users. So if you click invite new user, let's show you how that works. Where you obviously set the name, username, email, and password, and all that good stuff. But then you have three options here. So you have editor, which is basically the account that you get when you start with Easy Agent Pro, so you can access everything. You can set a CRM manager, whose role will only be that they can access the lead site CRM, but they can see everything that's available in there. And then you can also set agents. So if you have agents in your office and you want them to be able to use the website to make landing pages or write blogs, but you don't want them to see every single lead that you kind of have in the back end pot, this is where you do that. So you would set them up with an agent account, and then the agent account allows you to fine tune exactly what they are able to see. Brand images, kind of straightforward. This is where you can upload kind of some standard stuff, so like your headshot, your favicon, which displays in the browser, your brand logo, and your white logo. The white logo is something that a lot of people don't understand. So anytime on the website where there is, kind of a logo branding, you're going to see that in the header menu here. But your white logo is going to be something that would appear down here, like in the footer, anytime there's a dark background, anything along those lines. Colors, again, pretty straightforward. This is where you set your brand color. This corresponds with basically all the little accent stuff on the website, so it's pretty uniform, pretty straightforward. We tried to have, kind of give it a clean design in that regard. And then link color is what links are going to look like, which is set to royal blue. Menu section, this is kind of a big part of the kind of editing your menu here. This is where you can add new pages. So maybe you added, a page about, something in particular. So like if we go here, maybe you have a page that you written about, real estate deals in Knoxville or something like that. This is where you would add it to the site. And then if you were to add a page, you're going to see that it just kind of is at the bottom, but then you can click and drag it wherever you want to within the header menu. And then just go ahead and click save to make sure that you get that added. Password is going to be basically where you would go to reset your password if you ever need to. Legal is pretty straightforward. The legal section is basically where you can set cookies disclaimers and a GDPR compliance disclaimers. So, unless you're in the European Union, you're required to keep this on. You can also use it though, like you can click on that, to basically, let people know that they're gonna get cookies on the website and along those lines. The referral section is really great. So if you refer someone to our service and they sign up, then you get $100 credit. And then finally down here is billing. This is where you can sign into your billing center. So the billing center is where you can access like your invoices and things along those lines. Pretty straightforward, as far as that goes. Yeah, that's the settings section. Definitely not as sexy of a part of the website as, some other ones, but really important to know about. So If you guys have any questions about settings on your lead sites website, please let us know, and hopefully we'll talk to you soon. Take care.
Hey everyone, thank you so much for watching this episode of EAP TV. If you want to see more, click the circular EAP logo to the left to subscribe, or you can watch more videos by clicking on the links to the right.